measuring spoke length. Before measuring, please loosen the nut and washer. 100 millimeters.
Hub axle width.
33 millimeters.
Non-drive side to flange.
29 millimeters.
Drive side to flange.
225 millimeters.
Non-drive side flange diameter.
225 millimeters.
Drive side flange diameter.
Some rims may display ERT information. It may be difficult to obtain information from the manufacturer's website or point
Active
of purchase.
Rim diameter, ERD.
This method is used when there is no ERT rim information available. We will use gravity. We begin measuring the inner diameter of the rim from the valve hole. Insert the nipple onto the spoke in the direction of the head. Insert the nipple into the hole. Now mark the section where the nipple protrudes with a marker pen. Use vernier calipers. The measurement is 3.5 millimeters. Measuring the inner diameter of the rim becomes very easy. ERD equals 3.5 by 2 plus inner diameter of the rim. Add 7 millimeters. ERD equals 3.5 by 2 plus 560 equals 567 millimeters.
Effective rim diameter. Number of spokes. Spokes racing pattern. Select spoke lacing pattern.
Spoke length calculation is complete. Spoke installation. This wheel utilizes the cross pattern, which is the standard method of inserting spokes into the flange by alternating left and right. If the rim is too small or the hub flange is too large, the spokes will only be installed in one direction, from out to in on the flange. Installing the spokes. Widen the holes to accommodate 12 gauge nipples. Let's start by inserting them inside. First, attach the rim to the wheel truing stand. Please remove. Please remove. Secure the motor. Next, let's check the spoke installation sequence. First, install the spoke from flange side A out to in direction. Start installing the first spoke at the hole next to the valve hole. Install the first spoke at the hole next to the valve hole.
Then next here.
This is a pattern that jumps three holes. This is a pattern that jumps three holes. Bend and insert it into place. Perfect. First pattern is complete. All nipples should be exposed. Second step, flange B. Fit the spoke inwards from the outside. Now, install on the opposite side.
여기서부터 이렇게 해서 끼워줍니다.
Insert it next to the spoke you first installed. It's okay to bend it.
주시고.
Hub motors are easy to fix the spokes one by one.
이렇게 되고. 됐습니다.
Jump three holes and install. Third step, flange B, fit the spoke outward from the inside. Well, G spokes are difficult to fit into flange holes for 1000 watts motors. Good job. Put all the spokes in place. Now, install on this side. Put all the spokes in place. Finally, the fifth step is to install the spoke in flange A outward from the inside. Put all the spokes in place.
이렇게 해서 이쪽에 배치해 주시고요.
Now, rotate the hub with the spokes installed in the opposite direction of the valve hole to create a cross pattern. When the bike wheel spokes cross, the last spoke that meets does not simply pass by, but needs to be overlapped and connected to make a sturdy wheel. However, electric bike spokes are very thick, so they just pass by without overlapping. This is the only difference between electric bike and regular bike wheel spoke building. This motor uses a non-overlap pattern. Install the nipple head on the spoke. It's crossed.
Thank you, sir. And the toy, too. Yeah,
Complete one pattern on each side. The pattern is complete. Wheel alignment. Using a spoke wrench, you should be able to determine the start and end of wheel rotation while tightening the nipples. Attach a sticker-like tag to the spoke next to the rim valve hole. To tighten the spoke nipple, turn it clockwise. Tighten all the nipples while leaving a 1mm spoke thread. Overall tightening is necessary. Don't tighten too much at first. Firstly, we will explain the principle behind adjusting the rim left and right. By tightening the right drive side spoke nipple, the rim will move to the right. Conversely, tightening the left non-drive side spoke nipple will move the rim to the left. It is important to note that over-tightening the left spoke nipple can cause the rim to move too far. Releasing the nipple will cause the rim to move in the opposite direction. In summary, the principle is that the tension power balance of the left and right spokes moves the rim and aligns it to the center. Start the left and right alignment by tightening the nipples. The target tension is about 80% achieved. Using a dishing tool during the process can save time. Secondly, let's take a look at how to align the rim up and down. By tightening the peripheral nipples together, the rim will move towards the hub. To move the rim in small increments, tighten or loosen the nipples at least 360 degrees. Loosening the surrounding nipples together will cause the rim to move away from the hub. Vertical alignment of the rim only works when the left and right spoke tensions are adjusted together. Aligning the top and bottom of the rim is time-consuming. Reach about 90% of the target tension. When assembling wheels, the center can become slightly misaligned due to errors in the wheel truing stand. To correct this, a tool called a wheel alignment gauge, or centering gauge, is used. First, let's set up the dishing tool on the non-drive side. Attach the gauge securely without any gaps. Now, fix the gauge in place. Move the dishing tool to the opposite position. The measurement shows a gap of about 4mm. To calculate the rim displacement distance, 4mm division by 2 equals 2mm rim displacement distance. Now, we only need to move the rim by 2mm. Adjust the position of the rim by tightening the left nipple once and loosening the opposite nipple once. This will allow the rim to move without changing the tension of the spokes. Before starting the job, Label the spokes and check the starting and ending positions to ensure accuracy. Start the inspection again from the beginning. There should be no gap on the drive side, and if the measurement distances on both sides are equal, the rim is perfectly centered. Make sure to accurately position it in the center of the red mark. This side should also be positioned accurately in the center. Check the wheel spoke tension by hand to ensure that it is generally similar throughout. Using a tension meter, if available, is also good. Once again, align the wheel left and right while reaching the target tension of 100%. Align it with a margin of error of less than 0.5 millimeters in all directions. The wheel alignment job is now done excellently. Front wheel adjustment is completed. Install the rim tape. Pull it tight. The rim tape installation is now complete. Please subscribe, like, and leave a comment, as it would greatly help in making more videos. Thank you for watching.